Welcome back to part 3 of the 94th British Parks Senior Individual Merit for the final between Josh Towie and Chris Mardew. Let's rejoin our commentary team of Keith Rudman and Steve McHugh with the score at 3-1 to Josh Towie.
Now he's running the back of that. All of a sudden he's thinking the world's against him here. But he's an experienced enough player, he's won enough, he's played in enough big games, big comps, to know that nobody's won anything at 3-1. That's
good,
a great
ball. Good ball.
Still moving.
I think he'll make sure he's here, actually. I think whether he fires or whether he just plays it slightly over, I'm not sure.
He's playing at him with pace. Oh,
two.
That's unlucky.
Two for Towie.
Just clipped his own ball there.
Yeah, that's just the start Josh wanted.
I like this. I think this is a good ball. Should come to, it's gone the other way a little bit there.
Yeah, not easy though by the look of it.
Well, it's tight again here with this. This will come round the corner.
Short again, the pace has just gone out
a little bit. Whether he's done it by accident or by choice, he's picked an unbelievably hard bit of land there. If he'd have got away with it, it would have been a good move, but he could be two down here. And he's let Mardew back in. 3-5.
Yeah, that's a bit of a soft end by Josh there, I'm afraid. You know, and he's going to have to... He's not doing it on purpose,
no.
Of course, but you've just got to keep your percentage levels up when you're playing players like this.
You've got to make them work for every chalk, and you can't be gifting them. 3-5. More do you know? Playing this bit of land that he's played most of the afternoon here. Key to this mark is if you're a little bit tight at all, it swings like mad. It pegs violently. He's
good
played
ball
a good
this.
Ball here,
good
a
ball.
Good lead. Now then, Josh. Will he get it on the money or will he? Oh, well, he's certainly. It looks a little tight to me. It's got a swing yet. Just a fraction short as well. I think that might be what you said, Steve, about it going a bit. It's very lush down there. Sun's gone off. Certainly have to reach down there.
The sun's gone down behind that tree, just overlooking the land where they're playing.
Yeah.
And I just think that he's gone probably a yard slower in that area.
Yeah.
Doesn't sound a lot, but it can be crucial.
Josh, he's had a bit of a look there. He's had a look at what he's looking at. You know what he's got to do here. He's weighing up his options.
Well, both balls are together. Do you think he might strike?
Well, one goes, they might both go. That's what he's going to do. He certainly lets them go. Oh, he's over the top. It's five apiece.
I think that was the right ball, personally, but just didn't hit. And that's what I said before. You've just got to be able to hit at this level. You can't just hit to order, but you find a lot of players use it as a destructive weapon.
Yeah.
I don't think there's any danger whatsoever. The green has changed.
Yeah.
Look at this, it's short.
Yeah, it's definitely, it's catching him out now.
Yeah.
It's catching him out. Just limped in. Just limped past it, limped in, but what? A yard. 2'6" short. Mardew, has he put a bid in? Certainly looks further. He's got to miss the shortens. Not reached him. Ooh, that's a bit of a schoolboy error there from Chris. He might have just got caught out himself with the pace.
Another short ball here.
Well, he's room to go a bit wider. He even got a chance.
That's
he has
got
done.
One though.
Well, tell you what, they're getting him in twos here.
Four balls, nearest one short of the jack, a yard.
Not one person reached. Josh won't be too worried. He's got back in front. He's 7-5 up. But it's interesting how many twos are getting here. I think what we were talking about earlier about pinching chalks, I think now the sun's gone off the screen and it's playing that little bit heavier, I think you're going to see one or two opportunities to pinch chalks here.
Yeah.
Because despite these two lads have played all these games on it today, they haven't played it at this pace.
No.
That's a great lead.
That's a really good lead.
Great lead from the young man from Burslem Stoke-on-Trent.
It's a hell of an effort, this.
Oh, what a ball. What a ball that is. What a ball that is from Chris Mardew.
And that's what the good players do, isn't it, Keith? You've seen it time and time again with the good players.
I mentioned it earlier. It's not about bowling good balls. It's about beating good balls.
Oh.
And that was a classic example. If you've led that at Josh Towie at 7-5 up, and you've played one about 3 inches off the side of the jack, to watch Mardew lick it. We think he's licked it. There's not a lot of comment. But
I think this is what he should have done earlier when we talked when he was in, because, as you said, going finger peg over the crown before was nightmare to try and count.
Yeah. He certainly had a look at it. Now he knows exactly what the situation is as he plays this ball. With the length, there's no danger, but he's easing back a bit. I think we have to confirm that Chris thinks he's on. Yes, he is. It's one to Chris. As his partner just goes past me there with the brand. This doesn't look too bad, Steve. This doesn't look too shabby.
We talked about the Waterloo earlier, the maker of bowls, and the fact that he's done the sort of almost unbelievable treble on the green. It is a big green and big corners, and now the pace is going out the green a bit. You might see Chris really going for the full corners now. And
well, this is what we said a little bit earlier. I think he's a very versatile player. I actually think, and this might sound strange with somebody that's won what he's won, I think sometimes when you talk about Yorkshire, obviously people talk about Graham and they talk about Robert Hitchin and that, and Chris is not probably one of the first names that comes up, but you look at his CV and you look at what he's won, and his record of success and victories and competitions that he's won, he's up there with the best.
Well, I think he's the type of lad who doesn't seek the limelight. Pretty quiet lad, a really nice lad, Chris. Doesn't blow his own trumpet. Neither do people like Graham and Gary. But he just keeps himself to himself, Chris. And I think you're probably right. He may not have probably got the credit he probably deserves, because his record would tell you that over the past 10, 15 years, he's been as good as most. I think just coming this way is getting a bit quicker with the conditions, and going back to where he's just come is a bit heavier.
Push. Yeah. This has reached here now down this hill. Go a long way missing this. Oh, it doesn't miss. He's done his best to go out missing with a hit.
Might have gone off the green, that ball.
Well, it was certainly motoring. There was one or two people ducking behind it if it had missed. It certainly was doing the trip.
Running for cover.
Yes, this is a good ball. Look at this. Inch perfect.
Yeah.
Quality ball. Going back for his cap now.
You just get the impression this is becoming a key part of the game for Josh Terry.
This looks a better pace than his first.
He can only save, can't win.
No.
Not saved.
No. It's about breaking up the length, isn't it? It's about a couple of ends there. He's caught him short on the previous end. He sent one off the green with his first ball. He's short. It's back to them pinching chalks. He's just pinched four balls.
Yeah, it just shows you can't just send the balls. You've got to think about what you're doing as well.
There's, you know,
player one now.
Yeah, this is a good ball. Settle the nerves. Great ball. Good ball, lad. To be fair, Chris gave him a little bit of room there.
What were you saying, Keith?
I think he's got a chance. I think he likes it. I think he thinks he's got a chance. What a good ball. What a good ball.
I think that tells you a lot about Chris Mordew.
I really rate the lad, mate. I think he's a steady player.
I think he's a bit more than steady.
Yeah, but he's there every year, every tournament he's meant to beat.
No. Oh, what a
that's
good
that's unlucky.
Effort.
That's unlucky.
Yeah, that's 11-7, Keith. I think it's fair to say he's got to count in one of these next two ends.
You cannot allow Mordew to get settled with the block.
But as you said, it was 5-1.
Yeah.
So it's the last
7 now.
Yeah.
He's just won. You know, 10 of the last of the last 12 points as Mordew. It's a huge change in the game. And the thing is, if you're not playing the length, this mark that Mordew's playing is all about length. Because going down this slope here, if you haven't got a length, you'll shuttle 2 or 3 yard past. And he's played an absolute stone cold dead-end.
It's as though he's just pressed a switch and gone up a couple of gears, isn't it?
Well, that's the sound
gone
of
gone
class
through
players,
the gearbox.
It was 5-1 down, he made a couple of ropey bowls. It's like he just slapped his cell and said, come
What's
on,
what's happening here?
Over the top. Oh!
Oh, good ball, wasn't it?
It looked over the top, but you good have ball. To say, that's a great ball from Josh there. What a good ball from Terry there. He's fighting. He isn't giving up this title without a challenge. That was a fantastic ball.
This is having a look.
Don't look now.
Having a look.
Don't look now. Don't look now. I think he's only gone and won it. Well, that's what you call a chin dropper. He's looking at this, Josh. Can make two out of this if he connects right. Oh, he's done the gap. Done the gap. Well, he must think.
So Josh has played a good end the previous end, one down. He played a good end this end, one down. And that's credit to Mordew.
Josh, now then. He's pulled this a little bit tight here. Not one of his better efforts. Compose yourself now, Josh. Don't let things get away. You've had a couple of bad rubs, but you're still in this final. Improves all the time, Mordew. Big ball this at 12-7. Line two down, Josh. Took a little bit of a bump there. Has it done it the world of good? I think it might have done. Oh, he's just gone by.
See, you keep. Apart from that first ball, he's just sent at that end. He's played three good ends, you know, and he's not counted any of them.
Tell you what, he's got this mark off to a tee here. The pace coming off that crown down this slope here, which runs all the way. He has got it off to an absolute tee. Needs to hit here, Josh. Needs to pick the block up.
Ooh.
Needs to pick the block up.
Oh,
he's done the gap again.
Diabolical.
He's done the gap again. What's he studying between the semi-final and the final?
I think he'll have to watch what he's doing when he's crossing the road later on.
Well, like you said, Steve, he hasn't done anything wrong there.
No.
Played the perfect ball. He's gone right through a gap that doesn't look possible to go through.
And that ball looks to me, from where I'm standing, as though it's in the road.
He can probably get underneath it and sit on Chris's bottom bowl. I don't think he can over the top. Mordew, 2. 15-7.
He's just got into a groove now, hasn't he, Chris? He's just got this mark grooved.
The rhythm's going.
Josh is standing there thinking, just give me a bit of room, let me get in. Let me just get on the marks I want to play.
Now, he's just played to far here, Mordew, missing the block. That's the worst lead he's made.
Now then, he's got to punish that.
I'm not saying that's a bad ball, but it's 5 feet past where he's been adjacent to the jack. Wee a bit.
Yes.
Wee a bit. Go a bit past, missing, just stopped in. It's a yard past the jack. Looks like he's looking down at his cap there like he's sent a bad one. I think he knows that Mordew ain't going to go that far past again.
Won it.
Yeah, I think that's why
he's looking.
No
danger,
like
it's won it. Absolutely no danger.
You just can't give Mordew any room at all because he improves with that second ball. Now then, Josh, you have got a chance here. You've got to be up. You can hit the ball. You can hit the bowl. Give your ball a chance. Give it a chance. Block. Oh, yet again. The pace wasn't just enough to take it with it, but he's absolutely lucky.
This is not a 17-7 performance by Josh, is it? 17-7 down.
Not at all. Doesn't like that, Chris. And that's probably the worst lead he's made.
Yeah, for about 20 minutes.
Yeah. Got to punish this, Josh. He has to punish this ball. Run again, peg a little bit more, and find a bit down the slope.
Going right into the shadow there.
Yeah, he's played a fair ball, but you can't help but think, Mordew, you could lick that. That'll be a yard off. He's having a look. Is it a far?
Not a lot.
Yeah, I think he's gone out.
Yeah, it's gone out, you're right.
Now then, right, must make two. At least he's going to get the block back. At least he's going to be able to control where he goes. Got to run again. Find a bit down that there. Made two. Now then. Yeah, the applause comes in. I think that's the curve.
And then what would you do here, Keith? You think you just try and go over the middle again? He's tried that once. Would he try and go down an edge?
Would he go
in the full corners?
No, I don't think he'd go full corners with Mordew. I wouldn't go full corners with Mordew.
He's coming towards this edge. He's got to keep making a lead. If not on top of the jack, somewhere round about.
He needs to run a bit more down this slope for a good one. Down that final bit. It's what, 2'6"?
Yeah, not bad.
Got this out smoothed in, Mordew.
Can't
labouring,
get here.
Limping.
Can't get here.
No. If he gets round his own bowl and makes two here, that'll be game on, won't it? I think he plays a bit bigger ball than Chris. Certainly got round it. Certainly got round it. Good ball. Now then.
Now you'll see him trying to beat that ball, but his main priority is to save, giving two away
here. Well, his first ball's perfect road. He just needs 2 feet in his first ball. That's what he'd be thinking. It's more than 2 feet in this. He's a lot in this.
Left thumb.
To 13-17. Now it's game.
Credit to him. He's not let his head drop, has he?
No. Well, oh dear.
What a great effort this is.
Oof.
A great effort. Can't tell from here who's in.
No.
The referee not going to help us.
Nobody's asked. Nobody's asked a thing.
I just had the office from Peter Warfock at the side of me. He thinks that's won it.
Does he? Well, he's laughing and smiling, Josh. I don't know. Nobody's saying anything. If this doesn't pass the block, then I'm saying that it hasn't. Oh.
And a really
that
good ball.
That could be a good bad in that.
Only one.
And that's sticking out there.
Yeah, there is a ball to play here, isn't there, of course?
There is. He'll play.
Yard over.
Yard over on that ball at the side here. That's the ball. He's watching it. Likes it. Still looking at it. All the way down, he's looking at it. Has he reached? What a ball. What a ball that is.
Well, we did say it.
What a good ball. Well, you have to say that Josh played a good second ball, but the way they finished was a little bit unlucky for him by finishing at the side.
It was inviting, wasn't it?
Yeah, giving an opportunity. Inviting. But still, you have to be a class player to take it and play the right ball, which he has done.
Of course.
Because let's not forget, he was looking at going 14-17 there. Oh, well, he's having a measure.
He's having them pegged, yeah.
Are they measuring for two?
Well, they are. Kick one out.
Well, this would be a boosty bonus if he gets two. I'm sure he'd be happy. He should have been happy with the one, but you have to say it was a good ball of Mordy's there, because Josh had just got himself back into this game. That doesn't mean he's not in it at all. Nothing's said out yet. We'll see what the marker turns over. We know for certain that Chris Mordy's got back in. He's got hold of the block. He's heading back up to this bit of land that he's played so successfully all day.
Only one. 18-13.
Now then, Josh. Well, he's sort of he's beat it, but not with a good one. Mordy needs a yard, 4 feet in his first ball. Don't get too low. If you get too low, it throws off. Think he's all right.
Played a good ball here.
Look at that.
Now, can he see that to play at it?
What a good ball. I think Mordy's first ball might be in his way. Because if you play at
pace... Yeah, but the fact that is, I think he's got to come at it a little bit. Oh, he's coming the other peg.
Well, maybe he's playing at it the other peg.
Oh, he is doing.
Well, it'll swing violently.
He is
swing absolutely violently.
I don't agree with that ball, personally, but... Yeah. A little bit ambitious.
Chris Mordy. Good road. Good road. Length's not too bad. It's going to win.
Yeah, good ball.
In fact, it's a good ball. Massive ball this for Josh. Massive ball. You really seriously have to think.
Chance.
Close.
Chance.
Run a bit more. Well.
Won it, good ball.
I think that is a good one. Good ball.
I think you'll find Chris won't be short here. No, I'm not saying he'll just make sure he's at the end. Not overreach him, just make sure he's at the end.
He will think there's a ball here to win the game. Certainly played that ball. He's over the top. Can't sit the ball out. He's on the gap.
Yeah, nicely played ball by Josh there.
He's found one there, Steve, because that was a pressure ball. He was lying to be all but 14 down, and it's now 15-19. This will peg away.
Not an easy mark. Right on the spine of the green here, I think.
A lot of marks like this on here. Too far.
You'd know Keith being a green expert in the area.
I'm not a green expert anywhere, but I played it once or twice. Carried the mat a bit on here. You can see a lot when you're carrying the mat, Steve.
Yeah.
You pick up so many marks, you just can't play with. Now, I think he was a bit short as well, Chris.
No, he's roaded this ball. Yeah. Roaded
it's
this ball.
It's all about the length.
Yeah.
With the length, he pegs to it.
Yeah.
He's labouring.
Yeah, it's won it easy. Like we said, yeah. You can't give class players that sort of room.
This is the mark he played with success, obviously, in the semi-final. Into this corner. Thumb peg he's playing from where he is. It's push all the way. And then from this point onwards now, it's all downhill. And I think he's playing a good ball,
yeah,
Steve.
Yeah, this is a good ball. It won't be absolutely on top of the jab, but it'll look a lot
that
nearer stood
that
up there.
From good where ball. They've come from, is a very, very good ball.
Yeah.
This is an absolute knife edge of a mark.
Aye,
aye. Because if you get underneath...
What we're saying now, Keith?
Well, it's got to run. It's on a road. It's just labouring.
She's just going to die, I think.
It's a real effort. It's just an absolute
dying.
Real effort.
Good ball.
You know, 9 times out of 10, you would count that.
Now Chris will just try and play underneath that ball, but it might not recover.
If you get too far underneath, it slides against the peg. And if you come on the top side, above the jack, you'll whip bounce.
That's so what he's tried to do.
Yeah. I think he's too long.
No, it just won't look at it.
No, he won't have it.
But he's probably thinking that's if he licks that, good luck to him.
If he licks that, it's a real good ball, but he certainly has to reach because he could put his own in. If he tweaks it a fraction, he'll come over the top. I tell you what, it's on a dream road, it won't run.
Sure.
It won't run.
Chris Mordew.
Chris Mordew, the 94th winner of the British Parks Crown Green Individual Merit. And he's played well all day. He's certainly played well. That was a good final.
Yeah, I think Josh has done himself no harm at all, his reputation whatsoever.
It was a bit of a game of, Josh got out of the traps, he was 5-1 up. Chris took control of the game, looked like it was all over. But at the end, Josh has fought back and he's made a fight of it. I think he's played well.
I think it was that 15-minute spell from about 7-5.
Yeah,
up to about 16-7, 17-7 down, when, let's be fair, Chris played really, really well.
Josh, fantastic performance on reaching the final. What is a major, major tournament? How did you feel the day went?
I think the day went quite well. I wasn't expecting to get to a final when I turned up, if I'm dead honest. But, I wasn't going to come because the circumstances at home. But,
right.
I think I've done quite well. I've done myself proud. I didn't expect to get that far at all.
I think from people around the green today, you've got a real army of fans around the green today. And we're willing you on in that final. You went 5-1 up early on, and then we discussed it. Chris found a little bit of a mark out the corner over the top, which I think it's fair to say on about 4 consecutive ends, you played the perfect bowl and got no result by either running in the back of him or in knocking you, or you went through the gap. It must have been hard to just keep your composure when you felt the world were going against you.
Well, yeah. That's the game, isn't it? You make your own luck and, if it happens, it happens.
But you got in there and you fought back because, from being about 17-7 down, you're back in it, really.
I try my best. You can only do so much against somebody as good as Chris on his day when he's playing well. He's still one of the best of theirs, isn't he? And there's only so much you can do.
I mean, you've won a junior title, which was the Junior All-England back in 2011, I think we said there. Is this the furthest you've progressed in what I class as a major? To get to the final of this, or have you had other successes down in Potteries and things like that?
I've lost in the local Potteries Merit semi-final last year, and lost second game in the All England to Gary Ellis. I don't know what to say. I'm proud of what I've achieved, and well done to Chris. He's a worthy champion. He's still one of the best in the game.
Well, here I am, Chris, 2015 British Parks Association Merit Champion. How does that feel?
It feels brilliant. It feels absolutely fantastic. As I said earlier, I've tried to win this competition for many, many years, and I've watched a lot of winners, but never had the other than once losing in the final in '92. So I was determined to obviously get over the line today, and it happened for me. Fortunately, you need a little bit of luck, and I know I had a bit of luck in the final. Josh played all the right balls, and sometimes it doesn't, it doesn't come off. So. It was my day, and I'm obviously dead chuffed to have won it.
We'll talk about the final, but I can see that it means a lot to you for somebody that's been a great supporter of the Parks, as well as the ABA, but you've played in this competition for numerous years, so it really does mean a lot to you, not just saying that. You've been an advocate of the Parks, haven't you?
Absolutely. I started at Tysel Park many, many moons ago, and I've never left the parks, you know, as much as I've crossed over towards the ABA in the days when it was definitely a split. And obviously, as time's gone on, we sort of overlap a bit, but I've always remained loyal to the parks and played for Yorkshire. And so, as I say, it's the icing on the cake for me.
I have to say, you're developing a bit of a CV now with your collection of wins. You're up there with the best that there is. I mean, you know, the Waterloo, the Spring Waterloo, Champion of Champions, Talbot, British Parks. The list is endless, plus the other trophies you've won up and down. I mean,
yeah.
Do you sometimes think that you don't just get the credit you deserve?
I've always felt that, you know, strangely enough, I don't know. I mean, I don't think anybody can be as prolific as Gary Ellis and Graham Wilson and Simon Cowp, to name but three. But, you know, I've won a lot of competitions, obviously, but I've managed to win the big ones, which means a lot to me. I don't know. I mean, I know locally I'm, you know, held in high regard. And I just look over the years that probably I've not been invited to a lot of stuff that maybe I thought I would have done, but you know, that's how it is, you know, sometimes.
It's a strange final. You've gone 5-1 down, and then you've shot in front, and all of a sudden you're about 17-7 up, and Josh has come back at you.
Yeah, well, he's a great player, is Josh. I mean, he's a colourful character, and he obviously has a lot of ability, and even at 17-7, you know, I was determined to try and get a good lead on, which I didn't do, and back he came again, as you'd expect him to. But
I think in the final day, you just had a little bit of a spell where you played a little bit of different land, coming out of the corner over the middle, which is all run down the middle.
Yeah.
And you had about three or four ends on the bounce, where Josh was unlucky that he's found the gap for his run into your ball, but you've played a dead-length ball down the slope at pace, end after end after end, which has just pulled you away and changed the game, really.
Yeah, I've used that. There was like a brown piece of land that I tried just to get the jack over, and I were doing, as you say, just to perfection every time, and it just helped me did that.
We'll go back to the semi-final when you played Peter, which was more of you playing the corners and coming up into this, which is you tried in the final, but the versatility of switching the mark and something that didn't work, you didn't persevere at it all day, you switched it and changed it around, and that's a sign of a class player, Chris.
Yeah, I always think, you know, I try telling my lad Josh the same. I think you've got to have a game plan, and I know Peter had been playing that mark. I've been conscious of him playing it. So I thought, I'm going to play it. I'm going to let him start thinking about it. And I'll be comfortable on it. And it worked because he tried three or four times and then he went off it then.
And the old adage, you're going in there with the block, is the big difference. Well, there'll be two very, very proud people tonight, and that'll be your son, Josh, and your dad.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. I mean, my dad'll be chuffed when I give him the call, and obviously Josh. Well, Josh will probably just say, well done.
Will he?
Yeah.
Your dad will have it on Facebook later.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, my dad will have it all over the bloody place, no doubt.
Chris, many congratulations on winning yet another title, another major, which is what I call this, to go with the other majors that you've got onto the CV. And really, that's a double qualification for the Champion of Champions.
Yes, along with the Spring Waterloo, yeah. I don't know whether I can carry it. It would be nice to carry it over for next year, then. I won't have to.
I'm not saying they'll let you do that. What I will say, Chris, is I think you'll be a fantastic ambassador for the British Parks. You have been for many years. To win their golden prize, to win the British Parks merit, I think you couldn't wish to have a better ambassador going forward, taking the game forward, as the Secretary said there. Yeah. We wish you all the very best, Chris, and good luck for the rest of the season.
Thanks, Greg. Yeah, cheers. Thank you very much.
So I'm joined once again by Matt Hargreaves, the chairman of the British Parks Association. Matt, how do you think today's gone?
I think it's been a fantastic advert for British Parks, and it shows how far the association's come in such a short time. Really, really, really happy.
So I bet you can't wait for next year's Medic Finals.
Cannot wait. Hopefully I'll be playing in it myself. But I must say, Chris Morger at the end, it shows the difference between a good player and a very good player. Good players play good balls, and very good players beat good balls, and that's what he did all day. We're fantastic.
Have we a date and venue for next year?
We haven't yet. We're hoping it's going to be in Greater Manchester, but we haven't a date or a venue yet. They'll be released in November.
November. So, yeah, thanks for having us here today, Matt.
No, thank you.
So there we have it. The 94th British Parks Merit, and Chris Morger finally has a new one for his trophy cabinet. From all of us here at Harehill Park, thank you very much for joining us.
Online, on demand, on bluebordersports.co.uk.